In this video, we're going to add XML and JSON support for our web service endpoints. And what do I mean by that is when a request to get user details, for example, is made for a request to return user details, those user details can be returned in either XML representation or JSON representation, depending on what the calling client has requested in their accept header. Spring Boot provides a very good support for a JSON representation, and it's very easy and quickly to configure and to add a very good support for XML representation as well. I'm going to add one more dependency to my POM XML. I will open it in a source view, and I'll add one more dependency right after the Spring Boot starter web here. So that dependency is called Jackson-dataformat-xml. You can find it in mavenrepository.com, for example, or pause this video and type from my screen Jackson-dataformat-xml. And once this is added, I will save my POM XML and I'll go to user controller and I will add support for these two, get mapping and post mapping web service endpoint. Okay, so let's make our get user web service endpoint to support the response in XML representation. To do that, we will need to edit the get mapping a little bit, and I will add comma here. And to make this web service endpoint produce information in XML, I will need to add produces and then equal and provide a media type of the representation I want this web service endpoint to produce. And that is provided by media type dot, and then I provide application underscore XML underscore value like this. Let me import media type from org springframework.http. And this is it. By adding this produces, I have configured my web service endpoint that returns user details, return information in XML representation. But if I want to provide support for both media types, I want this web service endpoint to support both XML and JSON. For that, I will need to add the curly brackets at the ends, beginning curly bracket or opening curly bracket and closing curly bracket. And I will need to provide the second media type after the colon. So that will be media type application JSON value. And if I open the declaration of this application JSON value, I'll see that the value of it is a simple string application /JSON. Okay, and this is it that I need to do to make this web service endpoint to produce information in either XML or JSON representation. Now let's configure the create user web service endpoint. I'll copy this and I will update post mapping by including the produces in the post mapping, and I will give it a little more space. And one of the differences between these two web service endpoint is that get user accepts only a single path parameter, but the create user accepts a HTTP request, which is a post, and that post HTTP request will contain a request body that can contain user details in either XML or JSON, which means that our web service endpoint should be able to accept information in both formats as well. It can be XML format or JSON. To make our web service endpoint consume information in different formats, and in this case XML or JSON, I will need to add consumes equals to, and then I will simply copy and paste this values, and I will need to make consumes and produces separated by a comma. So I need to add comma here. And this is it. So now this is create user web service endpoint can consume information in both XML format and JSON format. And it can respond back with the representation of user details in both XML and JSON format. The XML or JSON representation is going to be generated out of this user rest object, which is a return value of this method. And if I open its declaration, it's a simple plain old Java object. It has class fields and getters and setters, and there's really no other annotations that we need to add in this case to make it convert into JSON or XML format. So let's save this now and let's run this application and see how it works.